Hello Galaxy Commanders and welcome to this video for Infinite Galaxy. Honestly, I didn't plan to make a video today, but maybe you already saw it. There are big news about not only the patch tomorrow, but a lot of patches. So I'll make this as short as possible and just quickly go into this. And here is the message we got. So, since the game got released and so on and so on, they are talking about cruisers, destroyers, frigates, the damage they do, and so on. I will link the whole text in the description so you can read it there, or just go to the Discord or to the Facebook from Infinite Galaxy. They do know that in the time at the moment, fleets are mainly composed out of cruisers because of which ship attacks always the closest, so they're going to change some things there, and so on and so on. They also say that it's like 65% of the total. It's very interesting, but the most important part is that they are going to change how battle works at the moment. So a little bit above there, they also say that at the moment frigates are very powerful, and I agree with that. When I checked data and tried to crunch it a little bit, I saw that frigates do have the highest attack per or damage per leadership point. And frigates now will get reduced HP and increased attack. It is important to note that from now on, these ships will not attack the closest ship anymore. They will first attack the ship that is the same as them. So frigates attack frigates, destroyers destroyers, cruisers cruisers, and next they will attack the weak ship affinity to them. So after frigates attack frigates and there are no frigates left anymore, they will attack cruisers. Destroyers attack first destroyers. When there are no destroyers left, they will attack frigates. Cruisers will first attack cruisers. When there are no cruisers left, they will attack destroyers. And now they will change the frigates to reduce the HP and increase attack. That will be amazingly powerful. They will increase HP and attack for destroyers. Wow. We don't know exactly by how much it is going to be increased. We don't know if this increase for the frigates is the same increase as for the destroyers. But that will change the dynamics dramatically. For cruisers, they are going to increase the HP slightly, increase the shield, and slightly increase the attack. So overall, it looks like they increase the attack of all warships. They increase it slightly for cruisers, and they increase it for frigates and destroyers. And I think that will change the meta that we see at the moment. I can't yet tell you if it will be mainly frigates or mainly destroyers. I'm really looking forward to run an Artemis then, and also the Hades. I know some people already have Hades out there. Unfortunately, I never found an Artemis player to fight the Hades. So this will get even more interesting. We already know about the changes for the crew members. So to allow us to do these changes as smooth as possible, they will introduce a few events that will more or less allow us to reset everything. So there will be an event that allows us to swap warships, meaning if you have frigates and you don't like them anymore, you want cruisers, you can exchange your frigates to the same amount of leadership points for cruisers. So 120 frigates in this case, they say, would be 12 cruisers. Both of them have then 360 leadership. As it looks like, we keep our tier ranking, so that is fine. Very interesting. We never saw something like this before. Another thing, we can also recast the flagships. And this does not only mean that we reset the XP, we can also reset the ranks. And we do get then advanced Federation credits. And they do have a note here. Flagships can't use, so three flagships can't use advanced Federation credits to exchange for blueprints. Odysseus, Prometheus, and Cyclops. Now, this is a very interesting information because right now the Cyclops can buy blueprints with advanced Federation credits. So they don't say it anywhere here, but it might be that we will see Cyclops blueprints being removed from the trade shop. Be careful about that. There'll also be reset for the core module, then there will be resets for the commanders, because also we do have a lot of crew members that are specific for cruisers, that are specific for frigates and so on. And this is another very, very interesting thing. They are going to buff the crew members. This is, I think, yes, it's more down here. But they also will allow us to reset them. So we can reset 10 purple or orange crew members. It seems to be limited to a total number of 10 crew members that we can reset. And we do get the crew XP as well as the ID cards back. And the ID cards will transform into infinite data cards that then can be used to upgrade another crew member. And that is amazing. For me, I do have, as probably everyone, I do have Laura. I did increase her rank at the beginning. You also do get a few data cards for her, but I don't use her anymore. If I can research her and use her data cards on maybe Paul, for examples, or yeah, Irving, we will see. That means I do get a very, very big boost in this. So if you do have any chance to get more crew members, you will get these additional ID cards we were already told. So you do get additional ranks, and then we can reset them and use these infinite data cards to upgrade any crew member we want. This is amazing. This is a huge step. We never saw something like this either. So two really big steps to allow us to change something. I don't know if this is the kind of event that will only be one time and then never come again, or if they might do have something like this a little bit more often in the future to allow us to change over a few things. I won't go, as said, I don't want to go into the details, it's really a lot. Important to note, this will be rolled out in different phases. So on June 9, this is tomorrow, the crew-related modifications will be implemented. On June 17, the new battle mechanics will get implemented. This is a little bit sad because we don't know exactly how they are implemented and how much what is getting boosted. But at least we can already reset our crew members. What we have here is crew-related modifications will be completely updated, and the crew reset event temporarily won't be available. That's interesting. So the crew reset event will temporarily not be available. I don't really get that. So that sounds like it's an event maybe we can do from time to time. We will see. But yeah, I think the changes that are coming there, they are huge. On June 17, the new battle mechanics will be implemented in server 1 to 5. So servers after server 5 will get it a little bit later on June 23. And yeah, I am, what can I say? This is a massive change. As said, we never had something like this before. This is at the moment my crew setups that I'm running. And if I check here, we can go for Laura. I got her on rank 4. Flagship output, research speed. I don't need that. If I can reset her and do get the cards and can use them, yeah, on Paul or on Rubia or maybe on Yiling, that will be amazing. Same also for some of the Epic crew members. You might have gotten, let's see, Dispatch Mastery level 4. Oh, here, Rapid Building level 9. I can reset Robbie and get these cards and use them on someone like Captain Goodman. So, my recommendation is really make sure that you think very, very well which 10 crew members you want to reset. You cannot reset all your crew members, so that's not possible, at least not from the text they shared with us. From the text they shared, we can reset 10. So for me, that will be Laura for sure. Very likely I will. I don't really have much there. I could try to get like the XP back if I see that I don't need any other skills. But I do know that I do have a few crew members with pretty high ranks here for the purple ones. And I might really reset them. And like also here, flagship output rank 6. This will be one that is perfect to be resetted because that will give me quite a lot of ID cards that I can use on someone who's much more useful for me. So it's already much longer than I planned to make the video. I will make a video as soon as we get the patch, and yeah, as usual, give the video a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, and then I'll see you on the next video again.